The rate of suicide among children and youth in China is increasing. They should enjoy their lives instead of electing to die. I am shocked by the news, stating that China has the highest child suicide rate in the world for the past 7 consecutive years. However, I doubt the credibility of the content.
And I took the initiative to collect data.
I found that, according to the data collected by the World Health Organization in 2016, close to 800,000 people die due to suicide every year. Suicide was the second leading cause of death globally among 15 to 29-year-olds in 2016. However,A prior suicide attempt is the single most important risk factor for suicide in the general population.
In China, the data of suicide death is incomplete because of lack of official data recently. But according to a sample survey concluded from the National Center for Disease Control and Prevention in 2000,250,000 people died from suicide every year, and attempt suicides were 2 million. Although this is important data, it must be said that this data is conflicts with the current data in recent years.
Now, suicide has become the fifth leading cause of death in China, and it is also the first cause of deathAmong people aged 15 to 34. Taking Beijing as an example, about 8.96% primary and secondary school students have mental health problems, and 8.57% students are marginal. A report of suicide-related behaviors among middle school students in China from 2000 to 2013.Shows suicide ideation, suicide plan, and attempt suicide are 17.7%, 7.3%, and 2.7% respectively. That means about 1 in 6 middle school students consider suicide. 1 in 14 middle school students had made suicide plans.And 1 in 37 middle school students had committed suicide.
Behind the statistics, they are all heartbreaking suicidal stories. However, we cannot conclude China has the highest child suicide rate from this data. When I made a deep investigation through the internet and government website, I found a keyword that is missing from the media's attention.That may potentially worsen the situation. Death education.
Death education for children and youth has different concepts and emphases among the world, but aims are similar. Promoting children and youth have a positive and healthy attitude towards life and death. It originated from the United States in 1960s.
If you'd like to feel the difference between life and death, you can touch Stanley. Stanley's very cold because there's no blood. You have lots of blood in you. You feel warm and full of life.
It includes biological aspects of death as well as psychological aspects. In case of emergencies, if any of their loved ones died. Similar systems are adopted in the Japan,UK and France. Japan used to make students raise chickens from eggs and eventually let students eat them, which were raised by themselves. The aim is to let them know about life. Hong Kong and Taiwan offer these related courses earlier. They are called life-death education. What's more,In Taiwan, there is a complete system of life-death education from kindergarten to high school.
发生什么事了？
他哥哥去世了。
哦，可 肯定是死掉了，是不是？
其实呢，它是一个生死议题的电影，原来还有一段哈这个创伤。
In contrast, mainland China has very few classes for adults, let alone youth regarding to death education.
没有说过死亡，很少说死亡的。
王小英, the professor in Northeastern Normal University, said, "Death education in kindergarten is blank, because people don't realize the seriousness of the problem, and the education system in China does not concentrate on children's mental health. They always care about children's grades."
每个儿童成长来讲，这一部分内容它就应该是教育的一个有机部分。我觉得青少年这一块也是缺乏这方面，我们可能把教育更多理解成这种知识技能的学习，就围绕着高考呗，高考考什么教什么。
吴婉晴, a student in Guangzhou University, who has taken life-death course, agrees with this view.
说中国的考试的压力，家长老师的期望，以及自己对自身的期望还是很高的。比如说我们高中，我们高二高三就只保留了体育课，其他课外的课都没有再保留，就感觉大家都非常的拼命，为了考试，为了高考，大家就不约而同的就削减了其他关于心理层面上的关注。虽然说中小学的时候也有一些心理课，但是我觉得他们的起到的帮助作用不是非常的大。
顾进, a deputy to the National People's Congress in 2019, suggested that death education should be developed in China.
我今年建议是在全民开展死亡教育这样一个话题。我们看到很多的社会上很多的年轻人啊，或者高中生啊，因为一点小事就轻生、跳楼，使我们感觉到其实对生死这样一个概念在我们的教育方面呢还是有一定的欠缺。
On the other hand, children have the consciousness of death when they are about 5 years old. If their parents can't answer their questions, they will feel confused and afraid. ThenThe other period is adolescence.
青春期的时候可能又是一个点，其实它都跟自我意识去发展是密切关联的。我说有一个说法我觉得挺赞同的，现在孩子是不怕死，但是怕苦，就是他对生命没有太多的感知，因为他的生活就是单一的，就是学习。
What's more, I found 3 other reasons that causes mainland China to lack death education.The first reason is, Chinese seldom use the word dead or even shun it. Some Chinese also discriminate against death-related industries, such as funeral and burial industries. Confucius said, "If you don't understand what life is, how will you understand death?" The Chinese.Have been deeply influenced by Confucius, and China has many tales about monsters and death. Maybe this is one of the reasons people are scared of death. So, when children ask parents or teachers, they don't answer the questions positively.
今天来的路上，他还在问我，他说：“小姨，你知道吗？我之前，你害怕死吗？”我说。我不怕，因为我离死很远。然后他说，我之前很怕死，但是我现在不怕死了。我说为什么？要不你过来说，告诉姐姐。然后我说为什么？他说因为我爸爸告诉我，他说人死了之后会去另外一个世界，3维的世界，然后我会以另外一种形式活着，是不是？所以他现在就说他不怕死，但是我们平时没有刻意的跟他说过这些。
这种东西又不是什么很好的嘛。
偶尔会说一下吧，就也差不多以开玩笑的方式这样子。
However, Chinese people are willing to tell children what the death is during the sacrifice day, such as Qingming Festival. Though, they will avoid the word of death.
很少谈，碰到一些危险的事情的时候会跟他谈起这个死亡，或者是在拜山啊或者什么的时候也会谈起。
some educators have a different point of view.
中国传统文化倒不一定，祭祀、祭礼啊，在某种程度上它担负着一种生死学教育的功能。
总是用那个孔夫子的那句话“未知生焉知死”，来那个说这个我们的传统文化不谈，其实这是不准确的。但是另一方面呢，实际上我们应该在民间去挖掘中国人面对生死问题的这个非常高超的智慧。你比如农村，我们老人家他过了这个六十大寿，他就暗示自己的孩子们，给我把那个棺木啊这些的寿就给准备好。然后那个老人家那个茶余饭后，就会走到那个停放自己棺木的地方，就停在那里看着，这个是非常宁静的一个画面，这也是非常美的一个画面。那么在这一刻，这个老人家看着这个停放棺木，看着这个东西，他怎么想我们不知道，但是他不恐惧，他在这个画面的生跟死是非常融合非常平缓的统一存在的。
The second reason is mainland China lacks a major in death education, which means there are few teachers in this field.
在中学阶段或者小学阶段的小孩子接触这些生死学的问题或者这样的一个学科呢，不是在于这门学科本身怎么样，而是在于能够跟小孩子讲清楚生死问题的师资非常难培养。如果你没有很好的老师，又在中小学中间去普及这种生死学的教育，我担心会欲速则不达，反而培养出了小孩子对死亡的恐惧。
我们的教师要懂得这方面的知识的这个修养，他没有一个比较好的表达的话语体系，他自己可能非常丰富，但是他们缺乏一种表达的话语逻辑，对他就不行。台湾地区已经把生死作为一个学科，作为一个专业的东西，这也需要从上到下的一个计划，他不能是民间的几个人感兴趣的几个人这个吆喝着，不能这样。
The third reason is the social atmosphere. Phone and computer games give children a wrong impression of death, because in games, player can be revived, and they could play again and again. The complete menu of suicide, Blue Whale Challenge, and live suicide broadcasts also have very bad effects on children and youth who don't have mature values. What's more, in business society, people always focus on money and life. Society lacks a positive attitude instead of a negative one, and tends not to think about death. Few realize that death can happen at any time. There is limited study of death education among both children and adults in China. There are only two universities, except medical universities, with courses related to life-death education in Guangdong province. Professor Hu Yi'an set up the life-death course in Guangzhou University 19 years ago. Every life-death class has attracted many students. This year, the class is divided into two parts. One is an online app, MOOC, and the other is an offline class, in order to satisfy more students. Professor Hu hopes people could consider death in their daily lives, instead of avoiding talking about it. Moreover, his life-death education is systematic, which includes death, suicide, disaster, and deathbed care.
过去是我们的文化，它忌谈死亡，回避死亡。我们进入到这个新世纪之后，人们对死亡的观念发生了剧烈的变化。互联网时代，很多这个年轻人呢，他参与这个网络游戏，还有这些那个影视作品， 包括这些这个动漫作品、动画作品，他们在宣传一种跟我们这个长期以来这个对生命、对死亡的理解完全不一样的一种观念。游戏中的闯关实际上就是复活，这种虚拟空间的这种理解呢，它很容易这个渗透到他对生命的理解之中，建构一种不恰当的这个生死观。生死教育可以说是迫在眉睫的必须解决的现实问题。
In his course, students will be asked to write wills and their epitaph. Many students are moved when they revealed their past life. In these 19 years, sick will written by classmates piled up on Professor Hu's bookcase.
那个作业就是让我们预立遗嘱，还有写墓志铭，分配你的那个遗产啊，然后让你对你自己过去的一生做一个总结。然后我就突然有点慌了，我就想到我可能会离开我最爱的人，然后他们失去我之后呢会有什么感受，就是开始会思考，就是死的意义，对这个课程的理解是以死去教育生。
A student wrote that not only should we respect our lives, but also we should respect others' lives, because life is equal. I think this is what the course taught him. More importantly, this course helps combat students' fear of death.
所以觉得对死亡还是有一种未知的恐惧。学了之后就会感觉人固有一死嘛，那既然最后结果都一样，那活着的时候就好好去体验生活，过好自己的生活，没有那么害怕死亡了。
In South China Agricultural University, life death education is taught from the perspective of Buddhism. Its emphasis reincarnation. The result is caused by people's previous births. It tells students death is not the end.And it is the start of the next life. The content concludes health, work, and life.
就是感觉会更敬畏很多东西，
就是找到了自己，然后再追寻自己的内心，然后去做自己想要做的事情。
Though this course in South China Agricultural University is different from the course in Guangzhou University.This course also helps students not to be afraid of death.
跟一些很不好的词汇挂在一起嘛，听到死亡就可能会很害怕，会很慌张。现在可能会比较坦然了吧，理解了其中的一些因果的原理嘛。
程宇红 ，a doctor in South China University of Technology, thought.Religion can really solve the challenges of death.
体系化的解决这个生死问题的一定是宗教。死亡不是一个科学的问题，你没办法，死亡问题无法实证，因为经过实证的，实证了死亡的人都死了，他没办法把这个经验告诉给你的，经验没办法被复制的啊，所以他一定只能从美学的角度，或者从其他的这样的哲学玄思的角度，或者伦理学的这样的一些角度，甚至社会学的角度，但是这些角度都没有力量，真正的力量是宗教的力量，他通过一系列的方式啊，能够让你感受到那种支持，那种力量。
In addition to death education in college classrooms, there are also forms from social institutions. Xinglai Death Experience Museum is one of them. When I heard about Xinglai Museum in Shanghai, I began my journey to find the meaning of the death experience.
Xinglai Death Education Museum is a pioneer in death education.They want to use games to give visitors a platform to think about the meaning of the death and life. There are some visitors who will experience it in this afternoon. I want to encourage people to concentrate more on children and teenagers' death education. 醒来 just provides a form to show it.
After participants enter the gate, they need to press their palms against a screen, make a deal between themselves and death. Then the door opens. 醒来 create a realistic environment for the participants to experience the near-death situation.
Ten visitors will have a chance to think about death.In this section, visitors are both strangers in the game. When someone is waited out by others, he will experience the death of social relationship. There is no answer of every question. Everyone is waited out depending on his behavior in the game.
Every experience normally includes a group of 12 participants.It is based on a series of ethical questions for them to discuss. After each discussion, one of the participants will be voted to leave the group. He or she then proceeds through the death experience. Mr. Liu is out of the game. Now, he is heading to the next section long.It goes through a pitch dark path and then lands on a simulated incinerator. There is hot air blowing onto his whole body, simulating the burning sensation of the process. And there is an electronic screen above him, showing the flames. After a short while of incineration,The screen turns from fair to a projection of universe. The incinerator bed also functions as a conveyor belt. Following the sense of the universe, the body will be transferred down to a point with small white balls. By crawling through these balls, the participant is reborn.At last, he enters a pure white room with lights to think about themselves and the value of life. The founder of 醒来, Huang Weiping, gives his understanding about death of social relationships.
我们在谈死亡其实不是，其实核心谈的不是那个生理上的死亡，因为死了就是死了，就说是啊，因为死亡本身就像陈丹青说的。毫无意义就说是的嘛
，yes， 就是我说比恐惧有胜于恐惧的，就因为乏味，它根本没那么好说的，就是像条狗一样死掉了，非常简单。
那其实就是我们的那个死亡教育的意义，就是希望把它放到这个生活当中来里面。其实我们，你朋友圈三个人，其实也是这个关系的死亡，就说是就意味着你再也不见这个人了。所以我们强调说这个死亡无处不在吧，就说。
Most participants agree that 醒来 is a chance to value themselves.
至少对于我来讲，不是让我对于死亡有了更多的探索，而是让我可能更坚定地知道自己应该选择什么样的价值观，然后去信奉什么样的理念，然后去继续更好的活着。
体验这个事，它本身并没有给我多大的改变啊，让我觉得要这样，只是让我有一个去思考它的机会，让我更真诚地去对待生活中的每一件事。
However, Jin Zi doesn't think 醒来 is a good model for death education.
醒来他其实开了一个馆，就是相当于我的平台在这里告诉你我有个平台，但是他并没有积极的去推广，并没有积极的去往外去主动的去那个主动的那个主动去推广，主动去告诉大家的那个东西没有。他只是在这里我告诉你我有，但是你按道理你真正要做教育做推广的东西，你要不断的去走向大众，不断的有东西端给大众，有现成的观点告诉大家，但是醒来是没有答案的，就是所以它是个哲学产品嘛。
醒来 will be closed in April 2019. One of the reasons is that they cannot afford the capital of running the museum, and the other reason is they are not accepted by the public.
投入这么大的心力，然后做这样的准备，然后。你等来的不是懂你的人，或者是 真的在好好用这个工具的人，就是那这个就是会让我们就是也是坚持不下去的原因，就说是啊。
But Huang thinks death education should be taught to children and youth.
死亡教育是可以应该早一点，因为孩子大概七八岁开始就意识到有死亡这个事儿了。因为教育它不是说灌输给他，你知道吧，就是我们先把教育理解错了，而是因为我要告诉他一个正确答案，其实没有。但是呢，这个呢，学校不敢承担这个结果，那我们敢哈，我们没有答案。你是应该让他给他就给他一些多这个去探索和多提问的这个就是让他把脑子疑问讲出来。如果他一直被憋住，甚至被压抑着不允许他这个探索的话，他就会在里面转。如果说碰到几个不正常的孩子嘛，一起就是对吧，引到别的道上去了。
She said she wants to have this related course during the third year of primary school.
他动物的那种生命的或者死亡吧，不要涉及到人的这个自然的死亡这种嘛，因为我觉得，因为还是幼儿园嘛，那小孩子接触这些的话可能有点早吧。觉得应该是上小学之后吧，他的那个心智应该有一些成熟的那个发展之后，应该比较容易接受，然后也比较容易理解。
初中的时候就可以开始建立这种思维了吧。小学阶段去做这个生死学的一个教育的话，是有利于我们去接受死亡这个自然规律。
No one has exactly answered in my interviews, but most of them think death education is necessary for children and youth. The difference is about the time. When children and youth should be taught the knowledge about death. But one thing is for sure. Children and youth should understand the subject. For example, when the child is around the age of 5, picture books can help them understand. The knowledge will change with the age. The aim is to let them discuss life from the perspective of death.
Martin Heidegger said, experiencing the death first. Which means,being towards death. He hopes people could face death positively, and then people could return to the true state of human beings, which helps them to create their own potentially valuable life. 醒来 Death Experience Museum is like a test in death education. Just like Zhuan Zi mentioned that, death education in China just started.
也是刚刚起步不久啊，以前是完全闭口不谈的，现在好像在开始慢慢的，所有的事情刚刚开始发展的时候都会是往各个方向的，它不会有一个主流的东西，或者说有一家独大，一家说哎做得很好，然后能够大家都认可它的那个就很难，一般都是相当于探索摸索阶段都会是百花齐放的一个样子。
There are many different ways of death educationIncluding courses in university or Death Experience Museum. Though death education in mainland China has met difficulties, the process of changing people's values needs time. Everyone believes it will become more important in the future.